Life preservers are located under the benches on the first and second decks. Life floats are located on the third deck. In the event of an emergency, crew members will assist you in their use. There is a snack bar on the bottom of this boat. If you're hungry or thirsty, I'd suggest getting something to eat or drink now. We have no beverage services available for you out there on the island. Mo will be happy to service you at your earliest convenience. On the other side of the boat, you guys should look out towards the Pacific Ocean. Both the Bay Bridge. Were built during the 1930s, so prisoners here on Alcatraz got to witness the construction of both of these bridges from a spot right here in the center of the bay. During the gold rush days, thousands of ships entered the Golden Gate, with passengers dreaming of becoming millionaires. Underneath the Golden Gate Bridge on the left-hand side, you can see a rectangular silhouette. This is Fort Point, a fortress constructed during the 1850s to defend San Francisco Bay from invaders. Fort Point, like Alcatraz, is part of a national park, the Golden Gate National Recreation Area. Because of the historic nature of the fort, the arch that you see stretching over it was specially designed by architects in order to save the fort from destruction during the construction of the Golden Gate Bridge. Alcatraz originally had the state use this fort point as a fortress to defend San Francisco from attackers. As you look ahead towards the island, you can see how its location, here in the center of the bay, just a mile and a half from San Francisco, made it an ideal location for a fort. You'll hear more about the fortress here on your guided tour this evening. As we circle the island this evening, try to imagine Alcatraz as it used to look, with huge cannons sticking out in every direction, warding off attackers.
Hi, how you doing?
This is my lovely husband Patrick, who's a heart of gold, puts up with such a wild, stupid girlfriend, wife, as me.
As you take your tour this evening, you're going to be hearing quite a bit about the human history of the island. As we go around the island tonight, I'd like to share a little bit of the natural side of the island with you. The island you see tonight is completely different from the island as it originally looked. The cliffs on this side of the island were blasted by the military to prevent attackers from easily reaching the citadel, which was located on top of the island where the cell house sits today. The tall spiky plants are called agave or century plants and were planted for defensive purposes as well as erosion control. In addition, almost all of the beautiful vegetation we see on the west side of the island was planted by its residents. Almost none of it is native to the island. Finally, the flat area here on the right-hand side of the island is known as the parade ground, was hacked out by hand by these first military prisoners. The cormorant and the black-crowned night heron. Nature has affected the island and its buildings in a number of ways. The San Francisco Bay is extremely foggy, and this rock here was a real shipping hazard. So the very first building on Alcatraz was a lighthouse to warn ships away. The lighthouse you see today replaced the original one at the beginning of the 20th century after the cell house was constructed. Just around the corner of the island here, you're going to be able to see one of the foghorns that was constructed here for one of the same reasons. Attempts in both the military prison days and the federal penitentiary years, inmates hid out in these caves, trying very unsuccessfully to elude their pursuers. Now here on the tip of the island is one of the island's two foghorns. The other is located at the extreme other end of the island, near the parade ground. The residents had names for these foghorns. They called the one by the parade ground the Bellowing Bull, and this one here, the morning cow. One inmate wrote that the two hardest sounds to get used to on the island was the bellowing of the foghorn and the rattle of machine guns from the rifle range. On one occasion, the fog on the bay was so thick that the prison boat was unable to even locate the island in order to land on it. The residents had to come out along the edges of the island and shout and wave lights in order for the captain to find the island. As soon as he was able to finally find the island and then land the boat, he quit right there on the spot. Now as we round the bend here and head for the dock, you can see two other structures that were built out here because of natural conditions. The water tower was built because Alcatraz has no source of fresh water. During all of its years it's been inhabited, humans have always had to bring over fresh water, on boat or by barge, how we still do it today. Also, this building here with the smokestack is our power house. We have to generate all of our own power here on the island. A number of attempts were made to run an electrical cable along the bottom of the bay from San Francisco, but the strong currents of the bay kept uncovering the cable, and it would snap a number of times by anchors of ships coming into port. We're going to be landing on Alcatraz in just a few minutes now. Before we begin our tours, just a couple of more announcements for you. You'll find restrooms at the dock and cell house level. Eating, drinking, and smoking are allowed only on the dock. So please finish your snacks and cigarettes before leaving the dock area. Also, please do not pick flowers, chase the birds, or remove anything from the island unless you've purchased it from our bookstore. There are some areas on Alcatraz that are closed because of hazardous conditions or poor lighting. So please do not enter any area marked closed for your safety.